Hello, I'm Boyan, and welcome to PMTV UK. Today, I'm here with Andy from our Manchester store. Say hello.
Hello, how you doing?
And he's going to explain two products for us today, so go ahead, Andy.
Thanks. We've got the brand new Boss RC202, which is a two-track tabletop looper. So you might have seen it's got a bigger brother, the RC505. This is a smaller, more compact version. We've got two tracks that we can apply effects to and loop around as many times as you want. Loads of memories to store what you want to do. You can plug in a microphone, you can plug in a keyboard or your guitar, whatever you like, really. Sync it to other gear. It's a great way of getting some tracks down, making some music.
And what else?
The other thing that we're going to be using to make that music is this one, which is a Roland Boutique JP08 module with the K25M keyboard. These are a bit of a limited edition thing from Roland. There's a fixed number of units that they've made, and when they're gone, they are gone. We won't get any more of them. It's basically a faithful recreation of the Jupiter 8, all of the original sliders, all the controls, really fantastic sound quality. And we're going to use these two together to make a track just using the preset patches, prove that you don't really need anything fancy to get making great music.
So we're now going to go ahead and make some beautiful music for you guys, aren't we?
Exactly.
Okay, so enjoy.
Okay, so we're going to make a quick track using the RC202 and the JP08. The first thing I need to do on the RC2 is to put it onto a blank memory. So if I press the memory button, and then I have 8 banks of 8 patches that I can choose. So if I choose number 3, now we're on memory bank 1, number 3. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to set the tempo. So I've got this tap tempo button that's flashing. If I press that, we're on 120 beats at the moment, but if I turn that up to 130, just check that. Okay, and now we're good to go. So on this loop over here, we're going to build up a bit of an ambient one, and on track 2, we're going to build up our bass line and main melody. I'm just going to use the preset patches that come with the JP08. So a few kind of melody bits to choose. And also a bass sound that I've made myself as well. So let's get going. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to choose my first sound. I'm just going to when I first press the play record button on track 1, it'll start recording. So I'll just run through it first. Press the record button there, that started looping it round. So if I select a different sound, press the button again, you'll see it go orange, which goes back into record. So now we can start adding extra layers. And when we're in overdub mode like this, it's constantly recording, so you don't have to take it out of record in order to add in more layers, you just keep adding them in. So I press it again now, and now when it's green, it's not recording anymore. So I've added all the layers that I wanted to add to my ambient loop on here. So I can take off my guide rhythm that I was using on there, and we can change it to be something else. So if I push the setup button and select number 1, which is rhythm, push in the dial where it says pattern, I can now change that to be one of the other preset ones. So I'm going to choose number 11 for this one. Exit out of the setup. Just select my bass sound. When I press the rhythm, I can start playing that sound with it. Wait for it to come around. Recorded my bass line on track 2. Select a different sound, I can add a melody on top of that. So again, push it again, tip it back into overdub mode. See, I made a mistake on that note there. I hit the bottom one wrong, so I can undo it. So if I press undo, and this track takes it out, and now I can redo it. So now we've got our track going, we can start messing with some effects on it. So on this section over here, we have four track effects that we can use. So we have a beat, repeat, a filter, a slicer, and a delay. So if I play the beat, repeat, for instance, it will sort of stutter the track. I'm going to apply a filter. Or if I stop both tracks, the drums will stop with it. A slicer if I wanted to. And now what we're going to do is we're going to make a bit of a breakdown section using the filter. So stop the rhythm, apply the filter on it. And when you're in, when you are playing stuff in, you can also apply input effects, which if you record when you've got them on, it will record them, but otherwise it just plays them over the top. So if I use my lead sound again, with say a ring modulator and some delay, we can have things. We can apply pitch shifting effects. Or even sort of a lo-fi kind of element. Slicer to bring it back, so I'll drop out the slicer and bring this. Slicer when I bring back in the rhythm. And then the track comes back in. I can still apply my undo and redo if I want to take out the melody. Bring it back in for another repetition. Go. Obviously, anything that you plug into it, it'll record. So we've just been using this Roland JP08 here module here, but you could plug in any keyboard you like. You could plug in your vocal, put in your guitar. It'll just record any sound and loop it around. It's a lot of fun. You should check it out.
So we hope you've enjoyed the demonstration by
Andy
from our PMT
Manchester
store. So yes. We went through the first of all,
RC202.
Say
again. Boss RC202.
And the Roland JP08 or 08, however you want to say it. So thanks for watching again, and we'll see you soon.
Cheers. Bye.
Thanks. Bye.